Hallelujah, praise God. Welcome to All for Jesus Church. Good morning, everyone. We're going to have our service today, our Sunday worship. I'm encouraging everyone to prepare our hearts before the Lord and let's worship Him. Hallelujah, praise God. We worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Good morning, everyone. I'm inviting everyone to get your Bible, and we're going to have our Bible study today. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. I thank the Lord that we are here again with all of you who are watching, and it's good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Wherever you are in the house, God is there. Amen. Hallelujah. God is there as long that you worship Him in spirit and in truth. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. We're going to talk about today, about in our Bible studies, about how we live our life. Amen. Hallelujah. Our title for our Bible study is Living the Life of Christ. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Number one question, who are those to live the life of Christ? Let's open our Bible in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verses 17. 2 Corinthians 5 verse 17. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It says here, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a what? A new creation. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. So who are the people who need to live in Christ? The people who are what? Born again. Amen. People who have received Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Let's just open our Bible in John chapter 3, verse 3. Praise God. It says, Jesus answered and said to him, most assuredly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Amen. Hallelujah. So, those people are saying, oh, where on the Bible that it says you need to be born again? It says here, John 3, verse 3. Amen? Hallelujah. Praise God. So, the people who need to live the life of Christ are the people who accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. I know Jesus, but it needs to Jesus Christ residing in our lives. Amen? Number two question, what are the attributes or the characters of Christ, and what lesson we can learn as believers? Number one, obedience. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's open our Bible in Philippians chapter 2, verses 5 to 8. It says here, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who, being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God. Verse 7, but made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a bondservant and coming in the likeness of men. Wow. When Jesus Christ was here, did he obey God from the very beginning? When he was forming in a human form? Yes. He actually obeyed God from the very beginning. Even to the extent that he was praying to our Heavenly Father, let this cup be removed, but thy will be done. Amen. Even on the time that he was crucified on that cross, he was still there. He was still obedient before our God. And what can we learn from here? Since we are the believers, we are following our Savior Jesus Christ, we need to obey God's word. We need to obey God's will. Amen. Hallelujah. Number two, what are the characteristic or attributes of Jesus Christ that we will learn, we should learn from it. Number one, he's a prayerful man. We need to be prayerful. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's open our Bible in Matthew. Praise the Lord. In Matthew 26. In Matthew 26, verses 36 to 42. Praise God. Matthew 26, verses 36 to 42. And it says here, then Jesus came with them to a place called Gethsemane and said to the disciples, sit here while I go and pray over there. And he took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, and he began to be sorrowful and deeply distressed. Then he said to them, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even to death. Stay here and watch with me. He went a little further and fell on his face and prayed, saying, oh, my Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will. Then he came to the disciples and came them sleeping and said to Peter, what? Could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray, lest you enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. Being a prayerful person, hallelujah, we know that praying to God is our communication with Him. Amen? Just like what Jesus Christ did here. He prayed all the time. He prayed all the time to our Heavenly Father. And that's what Jesus Christ is trying to say to us, that be prayerful at the same time. And the Word of God say, pray without ceasing. Amen. Our prayer is not only a communication. It's not only a place where we can just ask. No, but it is an intimacy and a worship and a time with God. When people will say, well, I don't have the time to pray. The only thing I can pray, Lord, protect us, cover us with your more precious blood, and bless us in Jesus' name. Amen. But if we priority our God, then we will make a time in prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Number three, love. John 15, verses 9 to 17. Praise the Lord. John 15, verses 9 to 17. He says here, as the Father loved me, I also have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. Verse 11. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may remain in you and that your joy may be full. Verse 12, this is my commandment, that you love what? One another, as I have loved you. Verse 13, greater love has no one than this, than to lay down one life for his friends. Verse 14, you are my friends if you do whatever I command you. Verse 15, no longer do I call you servants, for a servant does not know what his master is doing, but I have called you friends, for all things that I heard from my Father, I have made known to you. Jesus Christ is the perfect love. Amen?
Amen.
And he came here on earth not selecting or not saying to the people, oh, you will be the only one. You're my favorite. I love you. No. But whoever you are, whatever you did, God is willing to forgive you, wash your sins if you come to Him. It doesn't matter if you're educated, not educated. No matter what your status is, God loves you. And in the same way, if He loves us, we should be loving person people as well, amen? Especially nowadays, hallelujah. We don't need those crab mentality and those hurtful words. No, we need to spread good news. We need to open our mouth and speak love, amen? Number four, authority and power. Praise the Lord. Let's go back to Matthew 28, verses 18 to 20. Jesus Christ is the one who's speaking here. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, All authority has given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples to all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. There's no other name. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen? Amen. Teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Amen. Hallelujah. Our Heavenly Father has given all the authority to our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Now that we are believers, what is it for us? Number one, knowing that Jesus Christ, the name of Jesus Christ, there's power in the name of Jesus. Amen. And number two, knowing that God, our Heavenly Father, has given the authority to Jesus Christ, it means anyone who believes in Him, anyone who is following Him, has an authority as also. So we should always be aware of the authority and use it. Amen? How could we use it? Read the Word of God. Claim the Word of God. We have the authority to cast out the demons, to lay us on the sick, and they will recover. Amen? We should always use this, know the authority and the power. Let's open our Bible in John chapter 14, verse 12. It says here, Most assuredly I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also. Amen?
Amen.
And greater works than this, he will do because I go to my Father. We should always know our authority. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. We are victorious. We are not kolelat. We're not on the tail. We're always the head and not the tail. And we can claim the Word of God. That's ours. The Word of God is for us. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Number five. Last one. Humility. Let's open our Bible in Isaiah 50 verse 7. It says here, He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He was led as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before its shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. What does it say? When Jesus Christ was on that cross, they crucified him. Did he complain? Did he say like, I'm going to do this to you? No. What did he say? Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they're doing. Amen. He humbled himself. He was born in a manger. He didn't say like, yes, I'm here now. Hello. No. He was born in a manger. Amen. And what else did he do? When he's doing the miracles, did he say, yeah, hello, I need your attention, I'm doing miracle here, come here? No. He humbled himself. Amen. Amen. In the same manner, we need to clothe ourselves with humility. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's open our Bible in 1 Peter 5 verse 7. Hallelujah. 1 Peter 5 verse 7. I really want to give more Bible verses, but we have a few minutes. So 1 Peter 5 verse 7, it says here, hallelujah, casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you. Amen. Hallelujah. 1 Peter 5 verse 5. Likewise, you younger people, submit yourself to your elders. Yes, all of you, be submissive to one another and be clothed with what? With humility. For God resists the proud but gives grace to the humble.
Amen.
This is very important. We can be a educated pastor. Look at me. I have this theology and all that. That's good. That is very good. But we have those things are there as a tool to share the Word of God, not to use it as a, hey, look at me. Oh, I have a beautiful voice. Hey, look at me. No. All the things that we do is for the glory of God. We have to humble ourselves. Hindi yung, oh, mas magaling siya. Oh, she's much more better. Oh, look at that church. It's bigger. Look at their numbers. No. Especially nowadays, this is a humble moment. It is a reminder for us to humble ourselves. Whether who we are, it doesn't matter.
Rich or poor,
lahat need to be quarantined. It doesn't matter. this is a reminder for all of us to humble ourselves before the Lord. Amen. Amen. And that's our Bible study for today. But as a conclusion, hallelujah, Romans 12 verses 1 to 2. Amen. Romans 12 verses 1 to 2. Praise the Lord. It says here, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. Verse 2, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. We will always have to yearn. We should always yearn, amen, to live like Jesus Christ, who is our living God, our Lord, who is our Lord and Savior. When we say Lord, it means like He's everything. It's not like I select only what you like, Lord. No. We have to live like Christ. Amen. And that's our Bible study for today. Praise God. I'm calling our praise and worship team. Praise the Lord.
Amen.